This is the training for level one in the North Carolina Department of Transportation Erosion and Sediment Control Certification Program. The purpose of the training is to prepare attendees for the exam, which is given in order to qualify for the certification. First, we'll talk about the certification, and in the end, we'll talk about the test. Your instructor is Richard A. McLaughlin, professor in crop and soil sciences at North Carolina State University. In addition to this online training, we also offer classroom and field training at the Lake Wheeler Field Lab in Raleigh. Let's talk about the criteria for certification. First, there are three levels in the certification program. Level one certification is for people who are directly involved in the installation and maintenance of best management practices on NCDOT construction sites. That would be you. Level two is for those who oversee all or major portions of erosion and sediment control on projects, including inspections. Level three certification is for those who prepare design plans for erosion and sediment control. These are usually engineers and landscape architects. There's more information and details about these levels and their responsibilities in the handout, which is also on this webpage. The level one person has a number of responsibilities. First is to be able to read and understand the erosion and sediment control plan. Second is to know how to install all the best management practices that we'll review later. And lastly, since you're the ones on the front lines, you are expected to report problems or expected problems as they arise. Under the NCDOT special provisions, a certified installer or level one person must be available for these types of operations. As part of the prime contractor's crew installing erosion and sediment control stormwater practices, any subcontractor also installing these practices, pipe installation crews in jurisdictional areas such as streams and wetlands, and construction engineering inspection transportation technicians who are inspecting best management practices. Here's an example of where level one people are usually needed. Let's say on a project, there are seeding, grading, concrete pouring, and utility installation operations all underway. How many level one people might be needed? Well, usually concrete operations do not need a certified person. So in general, it'll be up to three people needed for the seeding and mulching, the grading, and the utility installation, three separate operations. There is another private certification program which offers two levels of certification. These are either acceptable as a substitute for both of our levels or just level one. The goal of the certification program is to be sure there are knowledgeable staff on every project to ensure erosion and sediment control is taken care of. If problems arise, such as the following types of violations we'll discuss later, it is possible that the person responsible will lose their certification. Note that this is not certain, but it is up to NCDOT to determine. If someone has their certification revoked, it will be gone for a year. In that case, someone else will have to fill their role on the project, which could be a major hardship for an employer to find another certified individual. Once a year has passed, certification can be regained by passing the test again. Here are a couple of common questions about the certification. First, can a level two foreman substitute for a level one person? Yes, they can, but in that case, someone has to take the level two foreman position. In other words, no one can wear two certification hats on a construction project. Also, are certified people required on all DOT projects? Yes, if there's an erosion sediment control plan. The certification lasts for at least 3 years from the date of your test. In these examples, you can see you are given whatever is left of the year from the time you take your test, plus another 3 years. After that, you will need to be recertified by taking another test. All certified individuals have their name placed on a list that is maintained on the web. This helps everyone keep track of their certification, and it may help potential employers verify the certification. Here's a quick quiz. A level one person is needed on a project with an erosion and sediment control plan. Well, yes, if there's a plan, certified people are needed to be on the project. So now about the test. It's 43 questions, of which 30 have to be answered correctly to be certified. It's open book, so you can use a handout, book, any notes you take, etc., that are at your disposal. You cannot receive help from other individuals, however. You have 60 minutes to complete the exam once you start it online. That's the end of this module.